Afternoon. Sorry about the music for anybody that's ears are bleeding right now. Apologize, but that's kind of in the mood I'm in right now, especially with all this this new snow that you're seeing, which is a heck of a lot worse back home. It's April 19th. It's just shy of 1 p.m. I'm on my way home for what we're gonna call a long weekend, coming home from downstate Michigan, southwest Michigan. And yeah, on my way home, you know, it doesn't help to complain, and there's a lot of people that got it a heck of a lot worse than us, North Dakota, Wisconsin, and others, really bad. I'm hearing horror stories of, you know, I don't know how true this is, but all I can do is kind of believe it a little bit. That some of the storms were so bad, you know, with calving season, especially in South Dakota, that, you know, if you're spring calving right now, I'm hearing horror stories of 20, 30, even 40% death loss with calves with this recent awful storm that just came through. That is, that's awful. That's awful. But what are you going to do? Nothing you can do about it. You know, it's amazing. I had to laugh at myself this morning when I took off from Southwest Michigan. Don't get me wrong, it's still winterish down there as well, but it's nothing like here or even what I'm about to pull into back home when I get there. It's funny because I kind of based my thoughts and feelings on the weather that was down there, some of the things that were happening. Right now, I should be heading home. I mean, it's April 19th. I should be heading home, planning on, if not already done already, excuse the English, pulling out the chisel plows and the discs, the culti mulcher, and everything else, not to mention all the servicing on tractors. I should be home taking that out of where it's been nesting all winter and giving it a good service, getting it ready. No, it's going to be a while. It's going to be a long while before that happens. Right now, the way I see it, I don't know. Planting corn the first or second week of June? I don't know. We'll see what happens. One of the really nice things that might save us here from this recent awful snowstorm accumulation was the beautiful thaw and melting that we had before it came. It was thawing and melting so nice and slow. It was, I'm not going to call it a dry thaw, but it was just, it wasn't all at once. It was absolutely perfect. I will only hope and assume that that will save us from creating lakes of standing water on our fields. I did look at the 10-day weather forecast, which looked phenomenal. Starting today, we have highs in the 50s. I'm even seeing a couple of days of highs of like 56. I don't recall seeing 57. So that's going to help out. A lot colder at night, you know, in the early morning, but a real nice, helpful Yeah, calm thought. Anyway, now I'm babbling. Like I said, there's a lot of other people that had it a lot worse than us, so I kind of need to shut up. But this is, this is awful. Whatever, what are you going to do? Okay, heading home. Enough of that weather stuff. Heading home. Got a little list of things on my plate while home. One of the things I look at doing, because I really don't have a choice, I don't care to do this, but I kind of have to, is I'm looking at shipping more Holstein feeder steers to a sale on the Friday the 27th or 28th. I think it's the 27th. Well, with my schedule, which I'm not going to reiterate to you guys don't need to hear about it. My schedule is pretty packed up these days. I'm able to be home the day that they need to be shipped to the shipper, which would be that week's Wednesday. But I've got to kind of take some actions this weekend in preparing for that. I'm not going to be home that Wednesday till later, late in the afternoon. So one of the things I'm looking at doing, and I'll keep you in tabs here with a video or two, is I'm unfortunately looking at closing down the beef barn again, closing all the gates. And I'm looking at Saturday, corralling up all the Holstein steers in the steer lot for what I'm wanting to ship to this sale. It's going to be anywhere from, I guarantee 15, I don't know about 20. We'll see. I do want to hold some off because there's another sale that I'm really wanting to hit. I think the first week in May. So I need to make a decision while I'm home. But there's going to be at least 15 that are going to be going. So I'm going to need to close that corral system again. Get them in the corral. Unfortunately, they're going to have to stay there. Well, fortunately, unfortunately, they're going to have to stay there for about a good solid 4 days before I can load them up and get them out of there and open it back up to the actual beef herd. One of the positives of doing this, if you follow the videos, you've seen the steer lot. It's an absolute horrid mess, disgusting. So are the animals. Well, I'm not going to say that a dirtier animal at a sale barn isn't going to sell. Most cases are, you get a group of pretty filthy animals, guess what? Doesn't matter what kind of body condition they're in, they're going to sell lower as far as I'm concerned. I've seen it myself. I'm not wrong. One of the nice things about doing this is I'm going to put in probably a couple bales of that loose barley, round bales of straw. I'm going to put it in the shelter. It'll allow these animals to kind of clean up a little bit in that 4 days or so. And so that's the plan. We'll see what happens. Other than that, it's just getting home, normal upkeep, and probably a load of firewood and normal chores. So folks, that's about all I have. I'm just kind of checking in here, giving you a little update. I am on my way home, and stay tuned to a small handful of videos to come of feeding, probably some round bales. I got some round bale sales coming up too this weekend, which is real nice. And sorting and shifting around some animals on the farm. Hope everybody's doing okay. Talk to you sooner than later.